committed and intense practice of unclutching makes one firmly established in a higher state of awareness. Committed. That's a beautiful word. Dirghakalaha. Nairantarya. Dirghakalaha. The literal translation is long time. But Patanjali doesn't mean to say that you should go on and on and on practicing. Sometimes people come and ask me. The word long time practice almost seems to be like a word used to cheat us. It's like you give a technique and tell him practice forever. It can be like cheating. I'll be blowing my nose every day for 35 years. By the time I come back and ask you, you will not be there. People ask me, is it not like cheating? Please understand, here Patanjali is not interested in cheating you. No. When he uses the word long time, he wants you just to be mentally strong. That's all. Even if it is long time, I am ready to do. That strength. Actually, once you have an idea, I am going to do it for a long time, suddenly you will see that intensity awakens you this moment. Beautiful story. Every day in and day out, Buddha was meditating for more than 12 years. Morning he will sit till late night, next day morning again he will sit till late night, day in and day out. Nothing was happening. The story says, one day he decided, itam asanam sushyate sariram. Let the body disappear, evaporate in this posture. How many days I don't know, how long I don't know. I am going to sit till I achieve enlightenment. I am not going to be bothered about the time. I am ready to sit dirghakalaha. Please understand that word dirghakala means not just long time. Deciding forever. Buddha decides, I am going to sit forever. Understand, time is after all psychological. Time is after all psychological. The story says, the moment he decided he will sit forever, that moment he just became enlightened. Because all he needed was that intensity. Usually when you sit in meditation having an idea, I'll get up after 2 hours. Your mind will be just waiting for the 2 hours to end. That's all. You will not be meditating. You will not be in the present moment. If you have an idea, I'll sit till tomorrow morning. Your mind will be waiting for next day morning. It will not be in the present moment. When Buddha decided that I am going to sit forever, he decided I am not going to get up. So mind has no goal to go. Mind has no goal. When it has no goal, it just fell back to the present moment and he became enlightened. Here, when Patanjali says, dirghakalaha, long time, that is what he means. Decide, I am going to do it forever. Then suddenly you will see, you fall into the present moment. Time is after all psychological. Patanjali knows our mind, how our mind thinks, how our mind functions. I've seen people, when they sit for the meditation, that half an hour will look almost like 10 days for them. Really? In Vedic tradition, the time is calculated as gap between one thought and the other thought. That is the chana, one unit. In our tradition, we don't have the physical time. The Vedic tradition, the more importance was given to the psychological time, not to the chronological time. So even the unit of time, one unit is not 1 second, one chana. The chana is defined as gap between one thought and the other thought. If you are a meditator, person living in a high awareness, high frequency, one chana can be even 1 hour or 2 hour or 1 day for you. If you are living restless, agitated, irritated, usual mood, one chana can be micro millisecond for you. It depends on person, please understand. It depends on your awareness, frequency. There is a story, I have a story for you. One woman goes to the doctor. Doctor says, you have only 6 months to live. She was shocked. Oh God, can anything be done? He says, all right, marry an accountant. She asks, will that cure me? Will I become all right? No, don't worry. That 6 months will seem too longer. Time is psychological. You can see in your life, if you are sitting with somebody whom you feel connected, love, reverence, you don't know how time flies. Suddenly after a few hours you realize, few hours are gone. If you are sitting with somebody, boring, irritated, every 2-3 minutes you will see a watch, but time is not moving. Time is psychological. If you are in high frequency, 1 year will look like 1 day, not because you are forgetting the things, understand. You start forgetting things also, 1 year will, not 1 year, 10 years will look like 1 day. I am not talking about the people who forget things. That is lower level of consciousness. I am talking about the people who are in a heightened level of awareness. For them, our 1 year will be just 1 day, because the gap between one thought and the other thought is more. So our chronological time does not match with them. That is why in the Vedic tradition, the God's calendar is different from human beings' calendar. For us, 1 year is 1 day for them. That is why the temple created by Patanjali, this great master, created a temple in South India, the Dancing Shiva's temple. Of course, in Seattle we have Dancing Shiva in our Vedic temple. Nataraja. In the temple, they do only 6 worship per year, only 6 times service, because the temple follows the God's calendar. It was created by a being who is in high frequency, high consciousness. They follow their calendar. The temple follows their calendar. Only 6 times the sacred bath is done, because our 1 year is 1 day. For them. In other temples, every day 6 services are done, sacred bath is done. The temples which are run as per the human calendar. This temple was run as per the God's calendar. So once a year, only 6 times, the sacred bath is given. This shows actually the time space in which Patanjali was living. He says here, Dirghakalaha. Please understand, this is the key of the sutra. This is the key of the sutra. Many times people ask me, Swamiji, what is the beginning of a spiritual practice? What is the end of the spiritual practice? I tell them, there is no such thing as beginning or end. Beginning and end are same. Now, all you need to have is intensity. See, if that intensity happens, eternally this is going to be my life. Suddenly you will see, you will not bother about the end. You will be in the end now. You will be in the present moment. See, meditation is all about penetrating the mind and going beyond mind. As long as you have an idea about future, your mind will continue to survive, continue to be alive. If you decide, next 12 years I will meditate, be very clear, your mind will be waiting just for the 12 years to pass. So you will never meditate. You will be waiting for the 12 years, that's all. Afterwards, you may boast, you may just brag around, 12 years I am waiting, 12 years I am meditating, do you know? I am a seeker for last 35 years. Actually, there is nothing to brag about it in that. It's a shame. People come and tell me many times, these great intellectuals, well read, filled with knowledge, they come to me and say, my experience is your age. I just ask them, what were you doing so many years? It is not pride. Please understand, this is the way your mind cheats. As long as you sit with a particular technique, you think you will do for so many days, so many hours, till some time, there is an end, there is a boundary. Be very clear. Till there is a boundary, you are bound. Your mind will not come back to the present moment. It will be just waiting. All right, 12 years I will practice, then I will question you. 12 years I will see, I will do it, then I will see whether anything has happened or not. It is like just because of your own mind, you do not allow that to happen. You do not allow that to happen. You can see even in your day-to-day meditation, when you sit and start the Nitya Dhyan, the chaotic breathing, you will be just waiting when the Guru Puja will start. I have seen, the moment they start the chaotic breathing, after 2-3 times, when the Guru Puja mantra will start. Understand, as long as your mind knows there is going to be end for this activity, it will continue to survive, uncheat you. It will continue to postpone, play the game with you. It will continuously play the game. It will postpone. It will cheat. It will play all possible games. So when Patanjali says, Dirgha Kalaha, long time. Even long time word should not be understood chronologically. See, long time, immediately you understand, 100 years, 200 years, no. Dirgha Kalaha, it should not be understood in a horizontal way, in a vertical way. See, as long as you measure time horizontally, 20 years, 30 years, 50 years, 60 years, your mind will continue to survive. It will have that hope, after 20 years, what happens, let me see. After 30 years of doing pranayama, what happens, let me see. After 25 years of meditations, what happens, let me see. It will be waiting. It will survive just with this one idea, long time.